It's become a collection that just is so heartfelt. It really, really means a lot to me. The paintings are, they're very quiet and they're thoughtful, but they are sort of sunshine and shadow. They're very much come out of the Sussex spring that we've had. Just quiet, contemplative work. It's all a love affair. For me, it's a love affair with landscape. It's the places that I like to sit and think, and the places where you go to recharge your batteries, and just those precious moments in our life where we feel that sense of almost a communion with nature. It's about that for me. It's about searching out those quiet times, those precious times where you just immerse yourself in the landscape. It's almost as if there are something compelling me to tell those stories at this particular time, and that's the way this work happened. So.
This layer that I'm doing now probably end up being about maybe 5%, maybe 2% of the final painting. It's just building the layers and building up texture, so I can just afford to just see what happens. You can see how that's just going into the lines that were already there in the gesso. This is just the best fun. It's just like this is really playtime. Later on in the whole process, things get a bit more serious because you're getting closer to the final end point, and all of this work, which might take a few years, suddenly it gets really critical. Whereas the early stages, anything that I do, if I don't like it, I know that it can easily go because there's going to be so many more layers. So it's really like free playtime, this bit. Fantastic. Let's see what happens. What happens is you then can see all of the work underneath, the white on white, suddenly becomes much clearer.
I can create a painting within about a year, but generally speaking, they can take up to about 3 years to make, and the thicker ones do take that long because you have to allow the thicker layers of oil to dry, and it's just purely technical, and the nature of oil paint is that it has a long drying time. But I just have an absolute love affair with oil paint, and I don't find any other paint, because there's lots of paints that you can work much more quickly with, that dry much more quickly, and I could have the whole layering process concentrated down. Instead of spending 3 years, I could spend 3 weeks and have as many processes but without all of the drying time in between. But I never find that satisfying. It's the luster and the sort of quality of the colour that I can only get in oil paint that makes them so special. And also, you know that they're future proof. I mean, an oil painting lasts forever. We know we have oil paintings painted many hundreds of years ago which are still as beautiful as they ever were. You then pull through, and perhaps even pull up something like that, and then pull through, you start to see that it... It really is just playing with colour and how it mixes together. Yeah, really just seeing what it's going to do. I'll just put that in here. In a way, almost intentionally want to create areas that I actually don't like very much at this point, so that I can happily obliterate areas, because if it's too close to something that I want to keep at an early stage, that's actually a problem, because then I have to get upset about losing it. And I know that the whole journey of this painting is that each layer is only going to be present in a very small amount in the final piece. So it's quite a strange part of the process at the moment that I don't want it to be too lovely because then I won't want to mess it up later. But I'm just really seeing what I like. The way that I work, it's very much pragmatic. It was very much what came to hand. So my mother is a weaver and meant that she had a lot of, I'm not even sure what they're called, but long slats of wood that you beat down the weaving with that happened to be perfect for pushing the paint across. Absolutely love that colour. Okay, so what I'm gonna do is simply put my blade on there. That is really exciting because that gives you, it's sort of a pale wash, but it has lots of interest in it. And the colours, as they move across, so the pink mix that I put picks up some of the greens and yellows and then comes in sort of beautiful orange here into the green. So you just get these wonderful subtle mixing of colour in that one pull. So the colour makes sense in how it mixes. And I did that because that just gives me great pleasure. It's just so enjoyable. So I just got my favourite little bradawl, which I've had for many years and I love, and it's been a part of lots of my paintings. And just, maybe you can see close. I'm trying to do it with a colour that you can see. Okay. And just literally start to scratch into it because I love drawn lines. And then my father had a bradawl hanging around, so I just picked it up, and that was a really lovely tool to sort of draw with. And I just utilise in that moment what is there in order to push and pull the paint around. And certain things, like for example my bradawl or my little knife that has painted everything for the last about 8 years, I absolutely love. And they become almost, like, I wouldn't want to use a different knife, you know, they become very precious to you because they've seen you through all these different things. And yeah, I mean, they're simple tools. I just don't use a paintbrush that much. What's so important with paintings like this is that they just should be such a pleasure to make. And I just find it so exciting what paint can do. Always endlessly exciting. Every single time I start doing it, I feel like I'm in my own personal playing space. I want to call this painting Faith because it's a painting that I knew that eventually I was going to capture the thing that I was trying to capture, and I had to really struggle with it. And I also want to call it Faith because to me it's the sort of place where I find a place like this where I can sit and gaze into the distance and gaze into the landscape. That's when I find my own faith again, and the quietness that you need to keep on with everything that you have to do. Yeah. And these paintings are about that. They're about contemplation, thoughtfulness, quietness, finding a quietness. Yeah, so that's why this one's called Faith, because I feel like I think I got there. I hope so. I'm about to work into this painting with my sandpaper block, and this is actually a piece I've been working on now for about almost 2 years probably. So this is very close to completion. It's really, really worked. So lots and lots of layers. And what I'm going to do is just sand into it and just see whether I can pull out some of the history of the painting underneath. And I have no idea. I really don't know whether this is what we're going to see underneath it. And it's something that just do very gently. And sometimes I can spend many hours just working into the surface very gently until something happens. So whether it'll be exciting at this point, we'll see.
So let's just see. We start here. Yeah, you're sort of just working away and pulling up some of the many layers that have gone down before. And obviously each time you do a layer, you have to wait ages for each one to dry. So I'm talking about going sort of digging your way through back through about 2 years of work. It's so exciting because you suddenly start to get little areas that I find just incredibly beautiful, almost like fossils or sort of precious rock or something. You get this really delicate detailing that you can only achieve in this way. Suddenly the whole thing starts to come to life. So I like it. This painting, because the oil has been applied so incredibly thickly, it's taken about 18 months, possibly even 2 years, to get it to this point where it's now safe for me to overpour the oil glaze. What this means is it's a painting that I've been working on for about 2 years, and in a few seconds that it takes to pour this on, I'm going to either be very pleased or we'll have to keep on working with it. Okay, so what's in here is a white oil glaze that I've mixed up. So that's basically white oil paint with thinners and walnut oil. So that's all just to the right consistency. It's sort of almost a bit like milk, I suppose. Enough to show up and not thick that it's going to be too claggy. And I'm now going to start pouring it. And then I'll have to work incredibly quickly to move it around in the right places. So pour it right down this edge. Okay. And then start to move it around and just push it into the, so it follows the lines that we've got. Push this into, just basically help it to move. Obviously, it's going to move naturally where it wants to go. You have to be brave. You have to be prepared to sacrifice things in order to get the entire piece to balance at the end. And so after it dries, I'll be able to work back into this and remove, if I want to, remove some of the white, depending how I feel. But we'll have to see how it balances over the whole of the two paintings. Okay. So there's times when I find it almost difficult to breathe. There, lovely. So yeah, that's good. I think I'm going to call this one After the Storm, but I want it to have that wonderful sense of after there's been a huge thunderstorm and then the lights, you know, the clouds move away and the light starts to glimmer through, and especially if it's tropical, you get this sort of steaming and just wonderful sense of, it's really beautiful, everything's glimmering after a downpour. So that's the sort of feeling of this. And it's also, to me, it's all about redemption and it's about hope, and that there are new
You know, it doesn't matter how dark things get, there's always after the storm, there's always that point when the clouds will lift, and you have to remember that. And I feel that really strongly. That's a really firmly held belief. So this painting is really, really precious to me. And I think it's nearly there. It's got a lot of, obviously it's taken a couple of years to make, it's got a lot of oil layering, which has allowed me to rub through and get some really precise detailing, and exactly the sort of thing that I love when you're seeing the different colours just glimmering through. It's got this sort of amazing, the way the paint's sort of wrinkled and pulled together, and then the overpainting's gone into it. You've got all these sort of almost bark-like or strange organic texture that I really enjoy. I've always found texture absolutely fascinating. Yeah, just very close to my heart, this one. This painting is probably the most dramatically different from when we saw it earlier, where I'd been working for probably a couple of years on getting that layering in the sky and all of that detail. And then I became, and have been for ages, completely fascinated by deep water and reflections within them. And I'd gone fishing, carp fishing. So we spent sort of 3 or 4 days just gazing into the surface of the lake, and came back and just decided, just was compelled to transpose those feelings and emotions onto this particular canvas. And it's now, I'm going to call it Gone Fishing. You can see the sky and land and all of those other things, but you get this extraordinary reflection of the weeping willows and the reeds and so on in those deep edges around the edge of the lake where the carp are sort of meandering in their rather wonderful manner. This lake is, I just think it's completely beautiful. It's one of the most lovely, peaceful places I know, and I come here often. And this is the lake that Gone Fishing, the painting I went a bit crazy with, was inspired by. It's such a magical place because whatever the weather, if it's grey, it's completely beautiful in the surface of the water, you see all the reflections in. If it's still, if it's raining, you get these amazing circles all over, and there's all these beautiful creatures here, and it's just a magical, secluded nature place. It's just fantastic. With a painting like Gone Fishing, the change, in order to work, it has to be brave. You have to be prepared to perhaps lose everything that you have created up until that point so carefully. It's like extreme sport. It's like, that's why I love to ski down mountains on black runs only, and that's why I like to gallop on racehorses. Certainly have to be prepared that you'll lose and you'll ruin that amount of work, and it is months and months and months of work. Of course you get attached, and of course if I do destroy something, I cry. I do. And the process is incredibly, incredibly exciting. I mean, I hardly breathe. The hours whiz past me and I just am completely, absolutely absorbed and fascinated and obsessed with what is happening, and scraping things away, and you know, it's all liquid and you can see things running over areas that you want to try and protect, and you're sort of just like, there's a sort of mania. It's wonderful. I mean, days like that you come away and just, that was what all of that work was for, that one moment, that really exhilarating final moment when it comes together as a painting. I'd love it if these paintings, just even as you glimpse as you're walking past, it gives you that sense of tranquility and that there is another world and there is a quieter time, and it's important to have a balance. They're very thoughtful and there are many stories within them, but I think if people feel that sense of peacefulness throughout, that would be lovely.